We know that customers often want that key parameter that's going to make everything run fast and flawless. But really, our general recommendation is to use the defaults wherever possible. The fewer parameters that you set, the better. Because the more you're running on the defaults, the more you're running in the environment in which we develop and test the database. So a very small number of parameters is generally your best bet to achieve good, stable, predictable database performance. You may want to set some parameters, even some undocumented ones, as we have here in this example, but we'll talk more about those as we go forward. What you don't want to do is use deprecated or desupported parameters, if at all possible. Now, desupported parameters you can't use, and it's worth talking about the difference between those terms. A desupported parameter is one that is simply not allowed anymore. And if it's desupported, then when you go to start up your database, it will not start. We will give you a message that you have an unsupported parameter there. You'll have to remove it from your P file or your SP file. A deprecated parameter is one that we reserve the right to desupport at any time. And that desupport could come in the next release update, it could come in the next full release, or it could come many years down the line, depending on the conditions. One example of that was the secure case-sensitive password parameter, which was introduced in 11.1, deprecated in a succeeding release, and is being desupported. With underscore parameters, and especially underscore parameters and events, these are generally undocumented, and you want to use those very judiciously and only under the guidance of support if possible. Use as few undocumented parameters as possible and only use them for as long as they're truly needed. So if you go querying the $V parameter view and you find a bunch of undocumented parameters there, that's when you need to begin the work to make sure that you understand, first of all, why those parameters are there in your init file. And second, when can you get rid of them? Is a parameter added to address a bug that you experienced in a previous release that's now been fixed and thus should be removed? Is it there because an application is telling you to set it and maybe you need to check the documentation when you do that application upgrade? Whatever the reason, you want to make sure that you know why everything is set in your environment. Now, I mentioned applications, and every application from Oracle-supplied ones like eBusiness Suite, Siebel, JD Edwards, or PeopleSoft to third parties like SAP might tell you to set certain parameters at certain values or based on system characteristics, and that's okay. The application gets to dictate your parameter settings for the database. But beyond that, you want to make sure that any parameters that you set have a comment in your init files so that in a couple of years, when you've forgotten why you did it, or when someone else is managing the database that you've configured, it's understandable when they look at the P file or the SP file to say, well, why is this parameter set? Or why is it set to this non-default value? So you can set that comment when you're setting the parameter interactively, or of course you can do it when you create a P file, and then you can query that nicely, even out of SQL Plus to find out what parameters were set for what reason in your environment.